Hello and welcome to Worship Matters. I'm Mitchell Crawford. Over the past few weeks, we've been exploring this amazing E.M. Skinner pipe organ here at Old South Church. Today, we're going to continue that and look more in detail at some of the characteristic stops of the solo division. The creator of this instrument, E.M. Skinner, was fascinated by orchestral sonorities, and his entire career was spent developing a symphonic organ. The solo division contains some of his most well-known and personal contributions to the art of organ building. So it's in this division that we find stops labeled orchestral oboe, English horn, French horn, clarinet, and these stops were all very characteristic of the style that Skinner was after.
Among the earliest of Skinner's innovations is the English horn, first appearing in the organ he built for the Church of Christ Congregational Church in Norfolk, Connecticut. However, it was at a concert here in Boston at Symphony Hall that Skinner first conceptualized the stop. Apparently, after a performance of the prelude to Act 3 of Wagner's Parsifal, which includes a prominent solo for English horn, Skinner was so captivated by the sound that, upon the conclusion of the concert, he went directly to his factory to see if he might recreate it with organ pipes. He worked late into the early hours of the morning, but succeeded in developing a prototype. The corno di bassetto was the orchestral forerunner to the modern clarinet. While the two names are sometimes used interchangeably, the corno di bassetto is often of a larger scale than the clarinet, with a fuller and richer tone. Skinner introduced it in the organ he built for Williams College in 1912. Skinner's most famous innovation, the French horn, was likewise debuted in the 1912 instrument for Williams College. He went so far as to have its design patented. Skinner left us his own account of its origin. Quote, "When the organ was planned for Williams College, Mr. Salter insisted on a French horn, and so one was written into the specifications. Before that time, Richard Strauss's Zalame was given by the Manhattan Opera Company, and I had heard 8 French horns in unison in the Zalame dance, and was from that time on determined that the French horn should be added to the voices of the organ, if I could ever get the opportunity to work it out." Skinner described the Heckelphone as a close-knit, pungent, and highly individual orchestral reed, resembling the English horn, but with more power. The Heckel phone is related to the English horn similarly to the way that the bass clarinet is related to the clarinet. Within the context of the symphonic organ, the Heckel phone functions like a bassoon.
The solo division contains three flute stops in imitation of orchestral flutes. The first, a harmonic flute, was made by E.M. Skinner, plays a concert pitch. Another stop, the Flauto Mirabilis, was made by the Schoenstein Organ Company and also plays at 8-foot pitch, concert pitch. There's also a 4-foot flute, which plays an octave higher than concert pitch. We can use them independently, like here, the harmonic flute. The 4-foot flute, which is a bit like a piccolo. Or we can use them together. The solo division is home to a set of string stops. Like most strings on the instrument, it contains both a unison rank and a celeste rank, intended to add a beat to the tuning in better imitation of orchestral strings. If you think about it, the strings of the orchestra are not one player, but many players. And while they're all playing the same notes, infinitesimal differences in pitch give a warmth to the sound. So organ builders have imitated this by the addition of a celeste rank to create that wave in the sound. I'll show you what I'm talking about. So here's the gamba of the solo division without its celeste. It's a stable sound. I'll introduce the celeste, and notice now there's a wave in the sound. So that can be further augmented with the addition of a tremulant, which affects the wind movement through the pipe. Slight undulation. Thanks for tuning in to this demonstration of the solo division of the E.M. Skinner organ here at Old South Church. Next week, we're going to continue with a look at the amazing variety of string tone available on the organ. So I hope you'll join us for that. Thanks again, and have a great week.